Ausgrid is under fire tonight, with tens of thousands of Sydneysiders still blacked out and with no real idea of when their power will be restored. The company wants to call in the Defence Force to clear debris that caused enormous damage above ground and, as we're learning tonight, below ground as well.
It's a 240-metre stretch of the new WestConnex M5 tunnels between the St Peters Interchange and Arncliffe, underwater since the weekend deluge.
Obviously my colleagues in the roads and WestConnex themselves are looking at that.
WestConnex says a temporary sump being used during construction didn't have the capacity to cope with so much rain in such a short time. It promises it won't affect tunnel operations when the project opens later this year. The Electrical Trades Union isn't convinced, warning the flooding will delay construction, with contaminated water blocking emergency exits, and it wants work to stop until all issues are resolved. Above ground, Ausgrid crews are doing their best to restore power across a vast sweep of Sydney from the north to the southwest. But 31,000 of their customers remain without power tonight, among them Andy McCourt at East Linfield, cooking on a camp stove and about to throw out a freezer full of food, just as he did when he lost power for 5 days after a storm before Christmas.
It's been proved twice now. For me once, my fault. For me twice, it's definitely the other person's fault. But they don't seem to have a plan, and they certainly haven't got enough people.
Despite the criticism, Ausgrid insists it does have enough people to do the electrical work that restores power. Its problem, the sheer volume of trees that have come down that still pose a risk.
The company has called for help from the Defence Force. The Energy Minister, also without power, says he doesn't care where it gets help from. He just wants Ausgrid to do better.
I don't have much hair left to tear out, but my frustration is representative of that, the 3,000 customers in my community and the 30,000 customers across the network that are still without power. And worse still, they're still without the information they need to make decisions.
We are absolutely doing everything we can to get our customers restored. And from where we sit, getting additional resources to remove trees is exactly what we need.
With the help, Ausgrid says all homes could be restored by the end of the week. Otherwise, it could well be next week. Eddie Meyer, Nine News.